So in last lecture we have calculated reaction forces. Now we will see a safety diagram for this example. Okay. Now first take portion AB. Start from left side. Take portion AB. Okay. Take any section xx at distance small x from A. That distance small x is variable distance. Okay. So shear force for portion AB will be a reaction force RA. Okay. Because shear force at any section is the resultant of all forces, vertical forces, either on left side of that section or either right side of that section. So in left side only there is a one force, and on the right side of this section there are 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4 forces, out of which 3 forces are vertical downward forces and 1 force is vertical upward reaction force. So after taking the resultant, that is addition of these 4 forces will be equal to 1, addition of these all forces, all 4 forces will equal to that shear force acting at this section. Okay. Shear force at section xx on portion AB will be resultant of vertical forces either on right side or either on left side. So here on left side, here only it is one vertical reaction force. So shear force Sx, x from A is equal to Ra, and we know that value of Ra is equal to 10.58 kN. So shear force will be 10.58 kN. Okay. Where x is, here this equation is hold for when x is between 0 to 3, and this shear force is constant. Okay, for point A to point B, just the left of B. Okay, shear force at point B, but just left of B, this is the value of shear force. Now we will see next portion, that is portion BC. Okay, portion BC is the second portion. So shear force Sx is equal to, see, the resultant of all left side forces, there is a one RA force and then there is a this 5 kN force. Okay, we are taking the portion BC, so section will Xx will be on this portion. Okay. So resultant of all forces on left side is Ra minus 5 kN, right? Ra is a vertical upward force, take it as positive. 5 kN is downward force, so take it as negative. So Ra minus 5 kN is a shear stress acting at portion BC. Okay, or you can also take resultant of all vertical forces on right side of that section. So 3 into 4, 12 kN, 10 kN, and RF is equal to 16.42 kN. So after adding this, that is 16.42 kN minus 10 minus 12 is equal, it should be equal to resultant of all forces on left side. Okay. So shear force at portion BC will be RA minus 5, where x is for from distance 3 to 4, x is varying from 3 to 4, okay, and that shear force is constant. Now shear force at point B, but just right of B, is equal to 5.58 kN. Okay, at portion AB we also got shear force at point B, which is equal to 10.58 kN, but this shear stress is for just left of point B, and this shear stress is for just right of point B. So shear force at just right of point B is 5.58 kN, and shear stress at point C, but just left of C, is equal to 5.58 kN, because this shear stress is constant. And the reason for this constant shear stress is that the load is here, it is only a point load, right? This is point load, and there is no load in between point B and C. There is no load, and that's why the shear stress is remains constant from point B to C. Okay, got it. Now take third portion, portion CD. The shear stress for portion CD is equal to sum of all forces on left side of that section. So Re is positive, 5 kN is negative because it is downward. Then again, portion CD, see, it is a UDL, uniformly distributed load. Okay, if we take section X6 at any section, any point on a line CD, then UDL will be the load acting due to this UDL is different for different length, right? If section X6 is near to C, then only little load will act. But if section X6 is on midpoint of CD, then half of UDL will be act. If section X6 is near to D, then almost all UDL will act, right? Right. So total shear force at portion CD will be Ra minus 5 minus small w, that small w is the intensity of UDL, and x minus 4 is a total length of UDL which we have considered, that is x minus 4. Okay, so shear force will be 10.58 minus 5 minus 3 into x minus 4. Here x is a variable because section x6 is it may be near to C, it may be at midpoint of CD, or it may be near to D. It may at any distance here. Okay, so section x is variable, so remain it as variable. And shear stress, the equation of shear stress will be 10.58 minus 5 minus 3 into x minus 4, and this is a linear equation because here x power of x is 1, so it is linear equation. This equation is for when x is in between 4 to 8. Okay, so at x is equal to 4, that is shear force at point C, just right of C, will be 5.58 kN, and shear stress at point D, that is just left of point D, is equal to minus 6.42 kN. Okay, this equation at point D, x will be C. At point D, x will be 8. At point C, x will be 4. Right? At point C, x will be 4. At point D, x is equal to 8. So by putting value eight in this equation, we will get shear force at point D, that is just left of D, that is equal to minus 6.42 kN. Okay. Now consider next portion, that is portion DE. Here shear force will be C at portion DE, that is from this to this. Okay. Section will be at any point. So either you have to take all forces on left, summation of all forces on left side of that section, or summation of all forces on right side of this section. Okay, so it is easy to take summation of all forces on right side of this section. So all forces are, this is the downward vertical force which is minus 10, and it is upward reaction force Rf which is plus Rf. Okay, so we will take all forces on right side of this section. Okay, so Ra minus 5, here it is taken summation of all forces on left side. Okay, here it is taken summation of all forces on left side. It's okay, you can take sum of all forces on right or left, any of one. Okay, so here it is taken Ra, that is plus Ra, माइनस फाइव माइनस थ्री इंटू फोर, ओके माइनस थ्री इंटू फोर दैट इज 12 किलोमीटर. सो इक्वेशन, सो शेयर शेयर स्ट्रेस और शेयर फोर्स एट पोर्शन डी विल बी माइनस 6.42 किलोन्यूटन विच इज कॉन्स्टेंट. द रीजन फॉर कॉन्स्टेंट शेयर फोर्स इज दैट देर इज नो एक्सटर्नल फोर्स और रिएक्शन फोर्स इज एक्टिंग इन बिटवीन पोर्शन डी ई, ओके देर इज नो फोर्स, ओके सो दैट्स वाई शेयर फोर्स इज कॉन्स्टेंट थ्रू आउट डी ई, ओके सो शेयर फोर्स इज माइनस 6.42 किलो न्यूटन. At point x is equal to 8, that is just right of point t, it is equal to minus 6.42 kN, and at point x is equal to 11, that is just left of point e, it is equal to minus 6.42 kN, which are both are same. Okay. Then consider next portion, portion EF, like same, take summation of all forces on either left side of that section or right side of that section. It is easy to take right side forces, but here we have taken sum of all forces on left side, okay. So take sum of all forces on left side. Ra is positive, so plus Ra minus 5 minus W into 4 minus 10, okay. This x is for x values varies from 11 to 12, okay. By calculating this, you will get Sx, that is shear force, is equal to minus 16.42 kN. Okay. This addition is a minus 16.42 kN, which is constant for portion EF, because in between portion EF, there is no external force or reaction force will act. Okay. In between portion EF. At point E and at point F, there is force, but in between that portion, in between that point, there is no external forces acting, or there is no UDL or UVL is acting. That's why the shear force is constant. Okay. So at point x is equal to 11, that is just right of E, minus 16.42 kN, and at point x is equal to 12, at support F, okay, it is equal to minus 16.42 kN. So we got all values at at all point on of a pin, okay. We got all shear force value. So from this shear force value, all values, you can draw shear force diagram. Okay. See, here it is a shear force diagram. See, beam AB supported by hinge support and roller support. These were the forces at point B. 5 kN, then CD, UDL, and then at point E, 10 kN. The shear force diagram will be like this. From point A to B, it is a constant force. At point A, 10.58 kN. At point just left of B, 10.5 kN. Okay. So the shear force is constant. That's why draw a straight line. Then just right of point B, there is a value 5.58 kN. And just left of point C, it is value 5.58 kN. So draw again straight line. Okay, there is a steep decrease in a shear force. Okay, at point B. Then again point B to C, it is a horizontal straight line. Then for UDL, that is point C to D, there is a constant decrease in a shear force. That is, at point C, it is 5.58 kN. At point D, it is minus 6.42 kN. And for UDL, that is uniformly distributed load, the shear force will be uniformly increasing or decreasing. Okay, intensity is uniformly increasing or decreasing. We have seen that in important point in shear force diagram, that shear force SFD will be 1 degree higher than loading diagram. This is the example. Okay, this is example. The later explanation we will see in next lecture.